Alright, so today I'm gonna talk of. It's a funny little machine I have here. It's a blood pressure machine style. You put it on your arm, you take your blood pressure, it has a little squirt thing. Okay, so today's joy is, well, I don't know. I started this morning out in a wretched mood, and then my father was not in a good mood, and things escalated, and he left, and he walked up the hill, and I was worried about him, you know, and so I'm like, well, I'll go visit him. So I went up the hill, and he was fine. And then I'm like, well, gosh, dang it, you know, I don't want any strife with him. I don't want anxiety build, especially older person, you know. And I'm like, well, so he went in there, he went to visit his sister, and he had one of those nurse ladies do his pressure. And when he came back to the house, he walked up all the way back, which is almost 4 miles. Okay, he's really like a marathon man. So his pressure changed dramatically. When he was up the hill, he was at 135 over 85. When he came back down the hill, 135 over 95. When he came back down the hill, he was at 124 over around 65. I'm like, wow, that's dramatic change. Okay, so I'm using this machine. Then I checked him another half hour later again, and then he dropped. He was at 114 over 65 again. And then I checked him one more time, very similar, right around that range. So his staying range, his just like around the house range, was at this 114, which is phenomenal, you know, for 80 years old. And his blood, what the interesting thing is, the pulse rate, this little cutesy toy, it also has the pulse rate, and his pulse rate is running 65. I'm like, how could his pulse rate run at 65? 63, 65. I'm like, that's impossible. Because I ran the machine on myself. I'm pretty much all the time 90 over 60 with my pulse rate at 85. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I am set up, you know, I'm set up. And back to his run on up the hill and everything, he runs. He drank a cup of coffee at the rest home. He drank a cup of coffee, and so he got all wired before he took this test with the nurse lady. So his reading was off because of the coffee. So let's bear this in mind. Coffee really affects this machine dramatically. Okay, so here I'm at this about 89, 87, over 59, 60, but I have this terrible pulse rate of 85. And the only way for me to get at it, because I don't exercise very much anymore, the only way for me to get at it is to take that meditation, that's it. With the deep breath, meditation and deep breath, and it lowers it by 10 to 15 within a short time, within 15 to 20 minutes. So that is the best way. Now, if you're running at 85 with your blood pulse, your pulse rate, your actual pulse rate, if you're running at 85 for a long time, you know, it's just your normal, that is what gives you heart attack. That's what gives you a tacky, they call it a tacky one. The tacky heart attack. I hate all this background thing. Yeah, it gives you the tacky heart attack, tachyarrhythmia kind. So yeah. So that's my direction I'm going in my health, is a tacky heart attack. Now, my dad is the other. He is the kind that gets jolted up just by, we will call it caffeine jolt, that it would raise him 10 to even 20 on his blood pressure. And because it's not the exercise. When he, after all of that exercise, it lowered him. It's the caffeine jolt. So yes, it's kind of been an interesting day. I'm out there seeking it out. I'm like, okay, I'll run through all of the goodies that we're supposed to have. Make sure your magnesium or your potassium levels are correct, your electrolytes, very important. Your breath, you have to take lots of these deep breaths, which goes back to meditation. Secondly, we have, they talk about this nerve, there's a vagal nerve, where you have to do like a block to release. I don't know, that's possible, use the vagal nerve. No caffeine, reduce your alcohol. What else? Of course, fresh fruits and vegetables, your greens. What else? A lot of that. So oddly, the vegan diet is very, very conducive to lowering your systolic and your, what's the other one? Diastolic. So very conducive. And so it's been a really good learning day for me and my dad also. He actually left. He went off to a funeral, of all things. A cousin died. So he went off to her funeral. I don't know, remembrance time. It was a fountain, a fontaine. So she's having her time. I never met her. Anyway, so interesting. So we have the tachycardia one, which is the pulse. So if you have a high pulse all the time, that means you're going to be like the one that goes, da, 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 done. You have the heart attack and you're done. Then you have the other kind, which is the run-up, which is just your blood pressure gets really high. Those ones are more prone to stroke. You see the difference? Now the stroke is the one that leaves you, instead of just dead, killed over, the stroke is the one that leaves you, you know, like, hey, I can't move my tongue, those types of things. So that's the difference. Anyway, so back to our health, back to yoga and meditation, and what else? Yeah, so and exercise. I really exercise pushers, and I'm not out there on the streets exercising. I'm not an exerciser by myself very well. So it's difficult. I have to do that in the house somehow. But anyway, yeah. So I'm not an athlete level. I'm at the 90-60 box. If you look at it online, they have this really cool little thing. You can find out where you are. I'm almost a heart. It chips away at the heart. This when you're the tacky kind, chips away at the heart, and it gives you stress on it, and so you keel over. But yeah, so it's great. I love this machine actually. I am really happy about its findings. It's an Omron. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to tell, but I got it years and years ago, with my husband. We were at some fair or one of those festival arts and crafts places, and for some reason that was for sale, and so I got one. Yeah. Anyway, that was really all I was trying to talk about today was health. And to lower it, and do not deny yourself the privilege of deep breath, because otherwise you'll end up like me. You'll just be that shallow hype, you know. So when you're in the shallow hype, that's that moment, That's also the moment we talk about stage fear and all of that. The shallow hype is what brings you to a bad for the heart. Yeah. Anyway. Yeah. I think when I was dancing, I was more like the 90-60 over like 70 on my pulse. I don't think I really ever had a very, very 70-72 was normal. I never really had a super low pulse, like in the 60s. And here's my dad. He's at 60, 63 and 65. And that's because he walks. He walks up these hills and down these hills. And so there you go, you know. And that's maybe 3 times a week of 4 miles each. And it really does help your health. Yeah. So anyway, so there you go. So you can be 80 years old and be 114 over, what did I say? He's 114 over about 70, about 65. And, yeah. So, anyway, that's the way to go. Exercise, don't forget it. Yeah.